And welcome back to Let's Play Star Trek Final Unity. I'm the RPG Chick. We're on the planet Horst 3 to look for Dr. Hunford or whatever the hell her name is. I don't know. I think we have a few more things we can mess with here. What about these field units? Oh, we have it! We have the field unit. We got them all. Oh, and those are the ones making the noise? And we have them. So what if... How do we use these things? What do we use them on?
The field unit is configured for a specific terrain and climate. It monitors the... The field unit...
What if we examine the field unit?
I see no way of using this with that object.
Can we get this thing back?
I see no way of using this.
Okay. Can we use the computer?
I do not believe that will work.
Why not?
A massive computer fragmentation has erased the doctor's files.
Ooh, really?
The only salvageable message from her daily log is sessions with tracker
mail. Oh yeah, yeah, we've
canceled.
Seen this.
Schedule again after field trip.
Okay, now what? Alright, let's leave, I guess. See if anyone else has anything new to say.
I wonder what was so interesting about these carcasses.
Didn't we do that already? Did we do all of them? Let's just get all of them. This is the boar, right? We found out about that. This is this. Can we identify this thing?
Subject is marked as a Kujan Gibbon.
Oh wow.
Probable cause of death is massive infection by natural parasites. Mm. This parasite is not native to the Kujan's habitat.
I must have used the same one twice. I think I scanned three of them, but definitely missed this one somehow.
The Kujan Gibbon was infected with a parasite which caused its immune system to collapse.
Hmm. It's not supposed to be here, is it?
This creature died of a parasitic infection.
I'll take a look.
It's been a while since I...
She said that before.
A normally benign Morassian parasite caused the alien Kujan Gibbon's immune system to collapse. The Kujan died of a preventable epidermal infection.
Hmm.
Dr. Hunforsch was examining these...
Okay. Okay, so we've identified this animal. Let's take it. Can we... Put it here with the sonic scope.
Serial diagnostic tests and cell density analysis complete.
Okay. So we still don't know what this animal is. Wait, where is it? I like it's telling us what they are.
Subject is marked as a myocordae mole. Probable cause of death. Is neural energy loss.
Right, didn't the scope say that?
This creature suffered an electrical energy drain from its neural pathways.
The electrical energy was drained from this creature's neural pathways.
How do you just do that? Drain electrical energy from neural pathways?
This creature has been drained of neural energy.
It's been a while.
She doesn't know anything. At anybody, even Worf knows more than she does. Okay. Then let's grab the thing back and put it here. I think we looked at it already. But now that we actually know what it is, it might give us more information.
Serial diagnostic tests and cell density analysis complete. Subject's neural pathways have been drained of electrical energy.
It's a cryogenically preserved specimen.
Alright, should we talk to this tracker person again? Now that we have more info? Open a channel to track our melas.
Channels open. I'd like to ask you about some animal carcasses we found in the doctor's lab.
Of course.
Right, ask her about the gibbon.
We found a Kujan gibbon which died from an avoidable parasitic infection. How could that happen here?
I don't know. The Watchers are the ones who care for the animals. Maybe they can help you.
How do we reach them? And also about the mole-like creature.
We did a bioscan on a mole-like creature. There was a significant energy drain from its neural pathways.
It's probably a myocordae mole. They're quite common on Marassia. But I've never heard of one dying like this before.
Myocordae mole? Is that what it is? Oh, really? Have we encountered a species that does this? I forget. It's been so long since I've watched Next Gen, guys.
I once encountered a species that consumed human neural energy. This animal looks like it died in a similar way. Maybe one of the animals in the preserve feeds on myocordae energy.
None that I know of. Perhaps the myocordae got caught in one of the generator power surges. But then it wouldn't be drained of energy. I don't know.
So then why even bother saying it if it doesn't mean... Never mind. You've been very helpful.
You've been very helpful.
I wish you well on your search.
Okay, what do we have to say now that we've looked at everything?
The constable did not mention these power outages earlier. Perhaps we should ask her why.
Okay, back to Constable Lixie. We're all bunched together because we were looking at that. So I can talk to all of them.
I'd like to ask the constable about those power outages Melas mentioned.
It's strange that Constable Lixie didn't mention the power outages. We should talk to her about it, even though I doubt she trusts us.
I was meant to talk to Worf. Oh, Worf can't talk to himself, right?
The constable did not mention the power outages. How can we determine what has happened if she will not give us all the facts?
Well, looks like she can't be trusted. And she doesn't trust us either.
That won't work.
Well, let's save. Before we leave this area, something horrible happens to us.
Worf is the ship's security chief.
That's very good, but I was really just trying to save the game. I commend you on your efforts, though. Oh, we're all the way here. Okay. Alright, back to the crossroads. This thing through the canyon biotope. Look at the mountains. I didn't realize. I was trying to look at that creature.
Everything in the preserve is beautiful and peaceful. It's quite an accomplishment.
Indeed.
Typically, preserves are constrained by expanding cities, forcing animals into a reduced habitat. I'm glad the Marassians gave these creatures plenty of room.
The preserve is one of the largest protected biospheres in existence. Its total area rivals the Ferguson Desert Habitat on Betko 7.
The Ferguson Desert Habitat, huh? Nice mountains.
A magnificent sight. I must bring Alexander here someday. He would enjoy it.
That's so cool you mentioned Alexander. Alright, let's go this way. Oh. We weren't here. We haven't been here before.
It is a crossroads.
There's a wormy thing up there.
That is the shuttle dock. This is where they quarantine the new preserve animals.
Hmm.
Nice tree. A magnificent sight.
Same thing.
That's the shuttle dock.
And
these are the main crossroads.
So we got dock, crossroads. Bog forest, biotope.
There's a biotope up ahead. A shuttle dock. The main crossroads. A biotope is up this path.
Alright.
These are the crossroads of the preserve. The paths lead to different biotopes. The path leads into a biotope. The shuttle dock is where shipments of preserve animals are received.
Okay. So it's not a shuttle that we use. No, we were beamed down.
That is the shuttle dock. There is a biotope at the end of this path. This is where they quarantine the new preserve animals.
Hmm.
This is where new animals are first brought.
What?
There's a biotope up ahead.
Okay. So, let's go to the constable's office. I think what we did is we went past the office somehow. Because they want to ask her about this. Greetings. Right. Tell us why this.
Could you tell me why Dr. Hyun-Forsch believed that animals were being smuggled into the preserve?
She found a Romulan creature, which is, of course, banned from import by Federation law. It was tagged as a similar legal species. She has accused me of smuggling it in order to damage our chances for Federation membership.
Hmm. How do you account for the animal, yeah?
How do you account for the mistagged animal?
I blame our supplier, Eremut. He's rude, devious, and barely competent. If I'd known Eremut was a Ferengi, I'd never have listened to Iydia's recommendation. But the contract is binding, and he does deliver on time.
Right. Exactly the opposite of their species. The females are slaves. And with their society, the males are slaves. Ask about the power surges.
Constable,
outages.
I understand the preserve has been experiencing some unusual power outages.
Those were just a few temperamental generators failing. They've been repaired. Is the Federation now concerned with our internal technical difficulties as well?
Listen, I'll slap you across the face. Why are you so opposed to the Federation?
Why are you so opposed to the Federation?
Membership in the Federation would compromise Marassia's freedom of action. Some of us would rather not see that happen.
Hmm.
Thank you for your time. I believe the Constable. She seems genuinely devoted to the Preserve, and I don't think she would resort to smuggling, even to thwart Federation membership.
Okay. Do we all get to weigh in on our opinions here? Just curious.
Excuse me, Constable. Has there been any contact with Dr. Hyun-Forsch yet?
No, I'm afraid not.
Just checking to make sure one of us doesn't say something different.
Has there been any contact with Dr. Hun Forsch?
No, I'm afraid not.
Okay, one more person. More Klingon. And we'll check the other crossroads.
Has Dr. Hun Forsch returned?
No, I'm afraid not.
Alright, let's get out of here. Looking forward to checking out these other areas. Let's go to the other biome first. The bog forest, or biotope, rather. I'm calling it a biome. More of these skull things.
It is a skull. Nice touch. This terminal is deactivated.
Ooh. Look at that thing. What the hell is coming out of its eye? Ooh. A Derwin tree.
Some of these trees have root sacs, which can provide drinkable water in an emergency.
Are we going to have an emergency?
Some of these trees...
Tunnel 2?
We must activate this computer kiosk.
What does that have to do with Tunnel 2?
We must...
We send those things into it, right? Those, field unit things? Mountains?
A magnificent sight. We did not come here for sightseeing.
These trees are thriving, and they're not even native to Marassia. These trees are... The kiosk might have the information we need to guide the field units.
Right, at least we have the field units.
The kiosk might...
You know, all these tunnels.
Derwin and Grotke trees are supposed to be difficult to grow. These are excellent specimens. The field units need the right coordinates to begin their search. This kiosk might have that information.
These Derwin and Grotke trees appear to be thriving. The preserve clearly uses excellent soil management techniques.
Soil management.
We do not know enough about the biotopes to accurately direct the field units. However, the biotope computer may contain the necessary information. This port can accommodate an external power source to run the kiosk.
We still haven't come across this
I do not believe that will work.
Power source?
This port can accommodate... I do not believe that will work. I do not believe... I do not believe that will work.
And, well, we don't have anything else but some dead animals.
I do not believe that will work.
Okay. Let us be gone, then. And go to the marine biotope. Probably won't be able to do anything there, either. Oh my god, we gotta wait so long for him to walk? Can we speed this up? Ooh, interesting. Jelly corals?
We do not know enough about the biotopes to accurately direct the field units.
Can't even look at them? They're pretty interesting looking, aren't they?
Intriguing.
So here we really have nothing to look at.
We must activate this computer kiosk. That does not work.
I do not believe that will work. I do not believe that will... I do not believe that...
Push skull. Alright. I saw that. Let's go to the quarantine shelter. Hello, quarantine shelter. Something burst out of it.
This panel controls access to the quarantine area. The gates open automatically in the event of a power failure. This is the harmonic collector control. The collector has been set to emit a brief high-energy pulse.
Interesting.
This panel controls the containment field. The field is centered on the harmonic collector.
What's this planetarium thing?
These generators create a network of force field segments to form separate containment areas. These generate... The harmonic collector operates on the same principle as the Bussard RAM scoop collector. Its purpose, however, is to reconfigure sound waves.
Yeah, I am so familiar with the Bussard RAM scoop collector.
This cage was broken open from the inside, most likely by the last creature it held.
A very strong creature.
Intriguing. Intriguing.
Field generators. Okay.
This panel controls the gates to the shelter. If the power fails, the access ways will open automatically.
If the power to this panel fails, the doorways will open. These are the gate controls. If you cut the power, the access ways automatically open to keep workers from being trapped inside.
How many different ways can you say the same thing?
This controls the harmonic collector. It has been configured to emit a brief high-energy pulse.
These are the controls for the harmonic collector. It's used to absorb specific sounds. These controls have been set to produce a brief, high-energy pulse from the harmonic collector.
So it absorbs sounds and produces sounds?
These are the controls for the containment field. The field has been configured to enclose the harmonic collector.
Worf is the ship's... We can activate the containment field from here.
Okay.
From here, you can adjust the size and resiliency of the containment field. The field's been set to enclose the harmonic collector.
The harmonic collector absorbs sounds. These are the generators for the individual containment fields. This cage was opened from the inside by a creature of impressive strength.
Indeed.
We did not come here
for sightseeing.
This harmonic collector absorbs the noise generated by spacecraft and other vehicles. It's probably used to protect the animals. These generators control the animals' containment fields. I doubt that whatever was in that cage enjoyed being there. Look at the damage it did getting out.
It's like, I'm getting the hell out of here.
This harmonic collector was probably set up to protect the animals by absorbing unnatural noises. The generator controls the force fields that separated incoming preserve animals. Something broke this cage open from inside.
Okay. Can we analyze to find out what might have been in there?
I am receiving readings of unusually high ionic residue.
Ionic residue? What would that mean?
These readings indicate unusually high ionic residue.
So I've heard, but what causes ionic residue?
I'm receiving unusually high ionic readings. I'm receiving readings of unusually high ionic residue.
Okay.
This harmonic collector was probably... These generators control the force field.
Okay, can we use these? Data?
I do not believe that will work.
It won't work. Yet he walks over to it and does nothing.
I do not believe that. I do not believe that. I do not believe.
Okay, I don't know what we're supposed to be doing with this stuff.
I'm interested in Dr. Iydia's part in this. Perhaps his comm channel is now open.
Which means we have to go back to... Right. We can't talk to them any other way. Alright, so...
I do not believe that...
Use the path by walking on the path. Mm-hmm. Let's go to the shuttle dock. And then we'll go back and... into the lab and see if we can talk to this... Iydia. Okay.
I believe this shuttle dock also serves as the customs area. As there are no expected flights, there is no staff.
Right. Oh, we need a microgenerator.
The microgenerator uses thermal energy to replenish its internal power source.
Right, so if we can remove that, we can use that on those biotope things. Charging unit.
This device recharges microgenerators.
Oh, so we gotta keep bringing it back here every time, if so? Microgenerator. Shuttle?
This cargo shuttle is powered by two 2,250 millicochran warp engines.
Millicochran?
The preserve is one of the largest protected by...
Okay.
The microgenerator can provide energy for a short amount of time. This charging station has been heavily used, but it is in good condition. It is designed to recharge standard microgenerators.
Exciting.
There is no power in this facility. It is a Wellen cargo shuttle.
A Wellen cargo shuttle.
It's a microgenerator.
It sure is. It's a charging unit.
This device recharges microgenerators. A full charge should last for days.
Okay, so hopefully we won't have to walk back and forth.
There is absolutely no one here. Apparently, the shuttle dock is staffed only during scheduled flights.
Because I'm picturing us removing the microgenerator, like charging it, going to one biome, having to come back here, charge it again, go to the other biome, and so on.
It's a shuttle.
That it is.
It's a microgenerator. This is a charging unit for microgenerators. It appears no one has been here recently. It's a shuttle.
Okay. See if anyone has anything to say.
I am interested in Dr. Iydia's part in this. Perhaps his comm channel is now open.
Perhaps Dr. Iydia can give us some useful information.
Perhaps.
Both Melas and the constable mentioned Dr. Iydia. Let's contact him.
Let's contact him.
I'd be interested to hear what Dr. Iydia...
Who do we not hear from?
I'd be interested to... I'd be interested to hear what Dr. Iydia has to say about all this.
Okay, I guess we did talk to everybody. Can we get the microgenerator?
I do not believe that will work. The microgenerator uses thermal energy to replenish its internal power source.
Okay. Is it already charged, or should I charge it? I guess we charged it.
I do not believe that will work.
Mm-hmm. Alright, let's go back and talk to Dr. Iydia. Walking. Go all the way back this way. Actually, we're close, aren't we? Yeah. Back to the lab. I'll be speeding all these parts up, guys. Actually, I really didn't have to speed that one up. That was pretty quick. Alright, let's see if we can talk to Dr. Iydia. Let's see if any of these other people can be reached at this point.
Open a channel to Grower Inongo.
Channels to Grower Inongo.
Healer.
Open a channel to...
Channels to heal...
Tiller.
Open a channel to...
Channels to...
Alright. Consultant Iydia.
Open a channel to Consultant Iydia.
Channels open.
I'm Lieutenant Commander Data of the Starship Enterprise. I'm investigating the absence of Dr. Hoon Forsch.
As I told Constable Lixie, I don't know where she is. Must you interrupt my research with more pointless questions?
Absolutely, that's what we're here for.
I'm afraid so. According to the constable's report, you are the preserve's consultant.
Yeah. So consult us, will you?
Yes, I help select and verify preserve species in the biotopes. The Morassians wanted a Federation expert, despite Lixie's objections. They were lucky to get me.
Huh. Well, fool yourself, aren't you? Aren't males considered slaves or something?
You were the last to see Dr. Hoon Forsch before her disappearance?
As far as I know, that's not a crime.
No, but it could make you a suspect. I'd like to know what you and the doctor discussed.
I'd like to know what you and the doctor discussed.
When I saw her for supper the other day, she was talking about genetic samples from the last shipment. She knows I don't like to hear people talk while I eat, so she said little else.
Oh, this guy's a jerk. Ask her about the cataloging.
But Dr. Hoon Forsch was cataloging Morassian species exclusively. Why would she want genetic samples from other animals in the preserve?
Right.
I don't concern myself with the lab work of junior scientists. Now, do you mind? I have important research to conduct.
You will pay us attention. I have questions regarding the carcasses.
I have some questions regarding several animal carcasses which we found in the doctor's laboratory.
Animal carcasses in an exobiology lab? Well, that's certainly unusual.
Oh my god, what a smartass. The boar?
A creature tagged as a Frednorian boar apparently died of starvation. Do you know how this could have occurred?
Sounds like incompetence to me. The watchers blindly follow whatever care instructions they're given. No personal initiative at all.
Throwing them under the bus, aren't you?
The boar's identity tag is incorrect. It is actually an Akana boar, a close genetic relative of the Frednorian. However, Akana are banned for import. How did this animal get into the preserve?
It must have been smuggled in. You know, the watchers have requested restricted species before and were denied. Dr. Hoon Forsch must have found out about it.
Consultant, I am puzzled. Since you verify preserved species, you must have known this was an Akana. Why did you not report the misidentification?
Bingo!
I didn't want to. I wanted the chance to study it. It was a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
Huh.
Who am I to deprive science of my brilliant research on such a specimen?
So he knew.
Did the doctor confront any of the watchers with her suspicions?
I think that's why she's missing. When she confronted them with the Akana, they must have stunned her. Those stunners don't trigger the surveillance system, so nobody knows about it.
Hmm.
Why would the watchers resort to smuggling?
They're fanatics out to save the endangered creatures of the universe. I've suspected them all along, especially when I discovered this mistagging. You see, these tags can only be reprogrammed by a watcher.
Okay. Talk about the cool John Gibbon?
A creature tagged as a Kujon Gibbon died of a parasitic infection not found in its native habitat. How could this have occurred?
I'd say it died of neglect. Those watchers don't know the first thing about dealing with animals. They're not scientists. They're glorified zookeepers. Why don't you go ask them about it?
I want to talk to you. What about this mole?
A mycordae mole experienced an electrical drain from its neural pathways. How could this have occurred?
I'd say it died of neglect. Those watchers...
You recommended the Ferengi trader Aramet for the second shipment.
Constable Lixie mentioned that you recommended the Ferengi trader Aramet for the second shipment.
He delivers what you want on time. The constable gave me hell when she found out that he was a Ferengi. She barely tolerates me because I'm a male.
Is that why you're so pissed off all the time?
Thank you for your time.
Thank you for wasting it.
Oh my god.
Iydia's accusation that the Watchers are fanatics is certainly plausible. Collectors can be quite zealous in their pursuit of rare specimens.
Iydia certainly has a high opinion of himself. The thing he seemed most interested in was his reputation.
What's that? I can't hear you all the way over there. Alright guys, thanks for watching. See you in the next episode. And endure. And enduring, cross-shine.